Dear higher power guy or gal,
his name is Jesus.
Good friend here in Tucson who is a UFO abductee. She's an experiencer. She's a former actress. She's very bright. She used to be editor for UFO magazine in California.
Really?
And just out of the blue, within the last 6 weeks, she decided to dump UFO interest and join the Catholic Church.
Oh, my goodness.
And I think, and this is like, what? Why are you doing this? I mean, in light of all the pedophile scandals and all this other stuff, why would you do this? And then, like, you know, just within a week or so, this whole Exo Vaticana information kind of fell in my lap. I thought, well, isn't this a very interesting synchronicity? I mean, what is going on here? So, you know, it's like, Mark, there's weird stuff in the wind, so just be aware of it and just watch what happens.
So, well, did she respond? Did she tell you why suddenly she went into the Catholic Church? And
well, she said she was originally raised Catholic, but she has not been an active Catholic, you know, throughout her life. And but she did have an abduction experience that was terrifying to her. But she called on the assistance of Jesus. She called upon Jesus to save her or to help her. And at that point, the abduction experience ceased.
Hmm.
So by her reckoning, it's like, oh, okay. Well, maybe I should be quit wasting my time studying UFOs and start studying Jesus.
Hmm.
And so this is this whole thing has rekindled her you know, Catholic origins, her Catholic upbringing. But it's very interesting how this you know, these events, this is the synchronicity in this is just very strange to me.
Is it a hidden message?
Get off!
Or a threat?
This is crazy.
Tyrell and Sean are stunned. Something has taken over the car radio.
Ryan, did you hear that radio station?
I did. Flipping through the stations like that, I've never heard anything.
Out of the car, Skinwalker researcher Ryan Skinner leads them to another hotspot.
When we were watching the ranch, we saw about 8 spheres of light that were pulsating on and off above and around the ranch house. And suddenly, 3 of the lights broke off from the group and started heading our direction.
Shh, hold on a second.
You all right, Sean?
Mm.
What you got, Sean? What are you doing?
Like spirits to come.
Sean's ritual pays off. Within minutes, a light appears in the sky. It's a UFO.
Look there. Look there, right there, right there, right there. Look at that.
Yeah.
Look at that. Look at that. Where's the camera? Go there.
You saw what?
I can't say what I saw. I don't know what I saw. I just know that I saw a light in the sky. It was an emerald in color. It was moving in between these two trees, and it closed like it was like a beat, and then melted into the sky.
Hold on. Did you report this? Because, you know, you're supposed to report any UFO
or
anything.
We did report it.
He did report it. He told us to contact Bigelow Aerospace.